of American Idol Season 10 is Scotty McCreery!
And the new artist of the year is
Scotty McCreery!
Tell her to say if you describe first, he's the one who got me here.
Casey, and new artist of the year, Scotty McCreery!
Work. Of course, thing, y'all.
How's everybody feeling tonight? Good, good. We are excited to be back. We played this place last year, and y'all were rocking. So we're going to have a good time tonight. It seems like it was just yesterday I tried out for that little show called American Idol. And, Lord have mercy. My life has changed. It's been such an incredible experience, y'all. That thing was something that we tried out for is kind of like a win. My dad had some frequent flyer miles and hotel points, and we were like, free vacation, why not? I'll have a cool story to tell. And then I got on the show, and thanks to you guys, I get to do this every single night. So thank you guys so much for everything I've been doing for me. I appreciate it. These last couple years, though, I've got to go halfway around the world. I've sung with all kinds of artists, sing all different kinds of songs. But for me, I like to kind of take a step back and remember where I came from. So we're going to do that here. We're going to sing my very first single called I Love You This Big. So I hope I made y'all proud while I was out there on the show. I know I found my heart, so thank you. But they were like, well, Scotty, you know, you gotta try some new stuff now, man. You're on the big time now. You gotta listen to some new stuff. So I wanted to sing some Jones and some Waylon and some Willie and some George and all the stuff that made country great. And they were like, why not listen to stuff like, or sing some stuff like, ra ra ooh ra ra oh ma la 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 ga ga ooh la la ooh la ooh man.
Lady Gaga? For real? Not me, not Scotty. So yeah, that took a little bit of getting used to it, and finally though, the producers in the song meetings, they started getting to where I was going and what direction I wanted to go with my music on the show. And week 8, week 7 was around the time of that. While we were in that meeting, I looked them all in the eye and said, y'all, I mean, it's simple, 3 words. I am country. Simple as that, y'all. So we're going to sing you a song now by the king of country himself, Mr. Yours Trey. It started way back in 3rd grade. I used to sit beside a little lace, a pink dress, a matching bow, and her ponytail. She kissed me on the school bus, she told me not to tell. Next day I chased her around the playground, across the monkey bars to the merry-go-round. And Demi Lou got caught passing me a note before the teacher took it. Come on, I read what she wrote. It is a good time out here on the road for us, man, and that's definitely helped out by the guys I have behind me, my band over here, Dry County, behind me. They're great dudes and fun dudes to be around and to keep life real happening on the road, I'd say. So, happening, I don't say that much. But, yeah, they're like my brothers, so how about we get with my band right back here, Dry County? Being on the road though, it's a little strange, it's a little different than life before. You know, back in the day we used to have dinner time conversations every night, see how school went, see how everybody's doing. And we don't have that as much anymore, so I miss my family, but luckily for me, I have my family on the road with me most of the time. My mom's out here today, and it is Mother's Day, and I am truly blessed to have a mother like her. She's been my number one supporter through all this, but even before this, she was my number one supporter. She's been by my side and helped me out through life and through those little things that boys grow up for and need their mom by their side. So I'm lucky to have her. Judy McCreery, she's out there. Y'all go say hey to her. Tell her happy Mother's Day. And happy Mother's Day to all the moms out here as well, too. Special day to y'all. We're going to sing a song now that's really personal to me. If you take it literal, it's about cleaning your dishes, but we're not going to do that tonight. This one's called Dirty Dishes, y'all.
Yeah.
this life, you know it drove mama crazy, the trip was live. The part she couldn't handle was being alone. I guess she needed more to hold than just a telephone. Papa called mama each and every night, just to ask her how she was and if those kids were alright. Mama would wait for that call to come in, but when daddy hang up, she was gone again. Clear as day, and hope you guys had a chance to check that out. I could have never imagined what that thing would have done for me. Y'all are good to me. Y'all got me through American Idol, and in 13 weeks, y'all helped make that baby platinum. Thank y'all so much for that. We appreciate you, but that was 2011. This is 2013. I'm ready for some new music. How about y'all? Alright, well that first one we played for y'all tonight called Rock This Night was a new one, and we're going to play out a couple more new ones if that's alright. This one right here is called Suntan. Girls on the lake, girls on the beach, and girls by the gonna take this time to introduce to y'all my band back here with this song right here. On the drums over behind me, this is Joey Sanchez, y'all. On the bass to my right, your left, we got Mr. Nathan Thomas, everybody.
Constant sorrow all through this day.
Yeah.
Sacrifice the music to get it that quick, if you know what I mean. I want this music to be the best it can be because y'all deserve that. Y'all been sticking by me. Y'all deserve the best we got. So I'm excited to be in the studio now. We've already cut about 12 songs. We're gonna cut about 5 more. We're gonna give y'all a lot this time. It's 5 more than last time. And I'm writing too. I want y'all to see what I'm thinking, what I'm feeling, what's on my mind. And so I'm writing some tunes, and my very first single off this next record is at the radio now. And I had a chance to write it. It's called See You Tonight. We're going to play it for you.
Girl, I gotta see.
Y'all are digging it. That'll be out in the radio pretty soon. I guess two years ago, somewhere in between there, I went out to Las Vegas and I was nominated for Best New Artist of the Year at the ACM Awards. And if you watch that video up there, I got to take home that hardware, but only because I was a fan vote of the award. You guys helped me out again, so thank y'all for that. Y'all are always on my side. I appreciate it. But we got down to Vegas. The ACMs were a Sunday, and I got down on Saturday. So, what to do when you're 17 in Vegas? Not much. McDonald's, a Big Mac, maybe. I don't know. So, guys, y'all understand, I'm sitting in my hotel room, bored, and I've watched SportsCenter. You don't realize it, but you watch SportsCenter 5 times in a row, and you're like, dang it, what the heck? Oh, I've seen that play before. He grabs it. There, nice play. So I was about sick of it. And I was like, look, I called my manager, like, what can I do here in Las Vegas that is legal? And she said, let me get back to you, Scotty, and I'll let you know. So 5 minutes later, I get a ring. It's from my manager, and she says, Scotty, would you like to go see Garth Brooks tonight? Heck yeah! So I got my things together real quick and headed down the road to the Encore. I got to see Garth that night, which was enough for me. A lot of people came into country music and they influenced it and they made it what it is today. But Garth Brooks came into the industry and changed country music forever. He did it his way, and country music is blessed because of it. So to watch a living legend like that, for me, I was blown away. I remember sitting crisscross applesauce in my living room watching the man on my TV, like, this dude got something going on for him. So yeah, he's the man. So I'm watching him, I'm just in awe. And when I go out in public nowadays and I'm not working, or I call this work, are you kidding me? This is pretty cool. But I come up with the hat and the shades or something, I'm trying to stay incognito or whatever, and I get a tap on my shoulder while we're watching Garth. Cover's blown. I look over, she goes, Scotty? Yes, hello? Hey, I'm August Brooks, I'm Garth's daughter.
Hello.
And she goes, hey, I'm a big fan, and we're excited you're here. Would you like to come meet my dad backstage after the show? Heck yeah! So I get up and I'm walking backstage to go see Garth. I ain't scared to death. But I'll tell you what, that dude, everything nice I've ever heard about Garth Brooks is 100% true. What a class act. What a great guy to represent country music the way that he has. And I'm sitting there, I'm talking to this dude backstage and he's eating pineapple. I'm like, ooh, Garth Brooks eats pineapple too. That's kind of cool. That's pretty cool. So, what a night that was. What a night. But watching him sing those songs was definitely the highlight for me. And when he was singing to us that night, he expressed that this next song I'm going to sing for y'all is his favorite song he's ever done, the song that means the most to him. And it's cool because I think this is one of the greatest country songs of all time.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared beneath the stars above. could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Now lives, they're better left to chance. I could've missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance.
Wow.
get situated. Here we go. Hope you guys enjoyed yourselves tonight. And I hope by now you guys have had the chance to see that World Vision video or the World Vision table we got up in the balcony tonight. It's an honor for me and a privilege to have them as a sponsor on this tour. And it's something that's very near and dear to my heart. I sponsor a kid named Mavice, and my family sponsors a kid named Keith. And it's one of the best things that we have ever done. We live in not a great country. We live in the best country in the world, y'all, the United States of America. We're going to have a good year, y'all. We are very blessed to be here. And this is one of those opportunities to share those blessings with somebody else. Which, in reality, what I found when doing this program is you feel like you're sharing your blessings with somebody else, and you are, but when you take a step back, you realize that you're really the one that's being blessed through this whole experience. So I invite y'all to go take a look up at the balcony at the table we got up there. It's a really big and neat thing to me, so y'all go check it out. I appreciate it. I do want to sing y'all a song out all by my lonesome up here, no backing or nothing, that I was doing back when nobody knew who Scotty McCreery was. It was 2009 was the year, and down the street they had a little idol showcase of their own called Clayton Idol, which was 10 minutes from Garner, North Carolina, where I grew up. I went into that whole competition, I guess you'd say. It was the first time I'd ever sing outside of church or anything. And I sang a song for my audition called Good Morning Beautiful. And I butchered that one. Lord have mercy. I was so nervous, and I went home and I was mad at myself, and I ripped up the music sheet. I was like, how could you mess this up, Scotty? And didn't expect to call back, but they called me back that night and they said, Scotty, we can tell you got potential, brother, but you're just nervous, so we're going to give you one more shot. And so I practiced and practiced and practiced and practiced on this next song. And it won Song of the Year 2009. Not because of me, but it's a really good song, too. Y'all help me out with it. It's all black and white, and it ain't real clear. Is that you there? You said yes, but I was 11. The times were tough back in 35. That was me and Uncle Joe. Just trying to survive a cotton farm in the Great Depression. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen your hand color. Yeah. Oh, this one here is taking overseas in the 1943, wintertime, and almost seen my breath. Well, that was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen him in color. All pictures are worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color. When I sing this song, I cannot help but think about those men and women overseas fighting for us and protecting this country every single day. I had two grandfathers. So how about it tonight here in New Jersey, we just give it up with those troops that fight for us every day. Well, this one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma in summer sun, all dressed up, the day we set our vows. You can't tell it here, but it was hot that June. That rose was red, her eyes were blue, and just look at that smile. Well, I was so proud. Well, that's the
story of my life. Right there in black and white. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color, yeah. All pictures are worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covering. You should have seen it in color. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. It's all black and white, and it ain't real clear as that you there. You said yes, well, I was 11. The times were tough back in 35. That was me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm in the Great Depression. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color, yeah. Oh, this one here is taking overseas in the middle of hell, 1943, wintertime. It almost seemed my breath. Well, that was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher, New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. All pictures are worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color.
When I sing this song, I cannot help but think about those men and women overseas fighting for us and protecting this country every single day. I had two grandfathers making the Air Force and always told me to appreciate those men and women. So how about it tonight here in New Jersey, we just do it up with those troops that fight for us every day.
This one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma in summer sun, all dressed up the day we said our vows. You can't tell it here, but it was hot that June. The rose was red, her eyes were blue, and just look at that smile. Well, I was so proud. Story of my life, right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color, yeah. All pictures are worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covering. You should have seen it in color. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Trying to figure out just what them me, but I guess that's the way it's supposed to be. Well, they smile and smile, they bat those eyes, they steal you in heaven, they kill you with goodbye, they hook you with one touch, and you can't break free. Yeah, the trouble with girls is nobody loves trouble as much as me.
Be a part of yours. It's not fair.
Well, Brad, I didn't know you were so sensitive, man.
Well, I am. Celebrities are sensitive people. They're people too, Scotty. And every night on that tour, we sang Celebrity together. And now I guess I just miss you.
Oh. Well, Brad, you know we miss you too, man. We had a great time out on that virtual reality tour last year. And thank you for having us, man. First country tour, we had a blast, brother. Singing Celebrity with you every night. Speaking of celebs.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Count it off. Don't screw this up. You sing the song for these nice people here today. And
we got it.
Just get back together and sing this song together soon.
Sure thing.
Someday I'm gonna be famous. On my way to rehab, 'cause when you're a celeb, I'm gone insane. I blame me on the fame and the pressures that go with it. Needing a slip.